Today's scripture is Hebrews chapter 11, verse 3. Hebrews chapter 11, verse 3. By faith, we understand that the world was prepared by the word of God, so that what is seen was not made out of things which are visible. Amen.
Flower offerings by a member in China. Congratulations on the opening of 2019 Summer Recreation, a festival of people around the world where wonders, signs, and powers recorded in the Bible will unfold. I believe that through the pastor Li Sunjin, acting senior pastor, the words of life that save souls are proclaimed and the strong works of the Holy Spirit are manifested, that the gospel of holiness and the works of power will spread among, you know, spread more greatly worldwide. We give all thanks and glory to Father God for leading me to my precious church and to meet senior pastor. I would also like to thank Pastor Sujin Lee, who is leading the church on behalf of senior pastor at the time of the trial blessing, and Mrs. Bonglim Lee, who leads the Daniel prayer meeting. We are so happy because of them. We are very proud to live a Christian life on this blessed church. I'm going to run hard and look forward to meeting with the senior pastor, sanctifying my heart and fulfilling my duty with all my heart and will. Let me introduce precious guests tonight. For this Friday all-night service, we have Reverend Myung-ho Chang from Nairobi Mamin Church of Kenya and Pastor Vladimir Osipov from St. Peter's Mamin Church of Russia and Pastor Alexander Samonov from Kaliningrad of Russia, and then Pastor Valery Drenogin from Perim, the Light of Truth Church, and Pastor Sergei Botsarnikov from Israel, and Pastor Alexander Lobozorov from Ukraine. And Pastor Alexander Azanov from Russia Christian Center Church, and Pastor Andrei Belayev from St. Peter's Mamin Church, and Elder Dmitry Krukov. We also have Pastor Dani Satrianto from Indonesia, and then Pastor Stanley Saroinsong from Bethlehem Church, Pastor Sandun Wizeskara from Sri Lanka. We also have Pastor Jang Jung-yeon from Colombia, Pastor Jung Kyung-tae from Tabata Mamin Church of Japan, Pastor Kim Jubon from the Philippines, Pastor Kim Hang-yeol from Peru Mamin Church, Pastor Kim Sang-hui from India, Missionary Kang Deung from France, Pastor Missionary Kang Min-gi from Kenya, Pastor Wilson John Gill, and Harun Imnan-gil from Pakistan, and Missionary Ang-hul-bayer Gan-batar from Mongolia, Pastor Sharon Cho from the Philippines, Pastor Song Suk from Cebu Mamin Church of the Philippines, Missionary Sharon Kang from Israel, and Missionary Robert Johnson from the United States of America, along with Pastor Lee Jae-chun from Taiwan, and Matthias Kasasa Elder from United Kingdom, and Pastor Chi Chung-hun from Malaysia, Penang Mamin Church. And we also have many members from Canada, Switzerland, Germany, Faroe Islands, Mexico, Malaysia, and China. They came to Korea to attend summer retreat. Now, all of our guests, please stand up while our congregation will welcome you with big hands. Thank you and welcome. In the second half of this Friday service, we will have 2019 Global Day. Please, I would like to ask you to have your seat before the second half starts. On behalf of Senior Pastor, Dr. Reverend Myung-ho Chang from Kenya will deliver a message under the title of Space, Dimension, and Science. Now let's welcome him with Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The church the senior pastor set up, upon hearing the news of Manmin and testimonies of Manmin, being reminded of love our senior pastor, I'm standing here. As I look at you, my beloved congregation, I miss senior pastor so much. I would like to share the love of Father God, so I give thanks to Father God. Greetings from the bottom of my heart. Father God, through our senior pastor, set up this church 37 years ago. His love is amazing. If we run by faith, we can win victory in this church. So this church gives faith and makes them true children around the world. And we trust our Father God and the Lord and our Senior Pastor. And Father God gives us strength back so that you know, we gotta receive the power of God. Without the power of God, we cannot work. So, pastors and all congregation of Manmin, whenever I see you, I'm amazed. In the space of Father, in the space of the shepherd, in the space of the shepherd, Father God has molded you and used you. Whenever I stand on this altar, whenever I think of senior pastor, I don't feel sad. Why? Because the way ministry of senior pastor is the ministry of victory, fullness, and the grace of God. Do not worry about tomorrow. Then you are Gentiles if you do. So I don't worry. How Father God will glorify our senior pastor. I'm missing for that day. As I watching testimony in Mami magazine, Amnit Ukuma of India, who had the disease, but thanks to senior pastor's prayer, since it's working around the world, you know, when people received it by faith, they can be healed and they can feel the grace of God, right, in this church. And especially Sister Imujin, when she showed her faith, Father God worked. Without showing your faith, Father God will not work. So I hope that, you know, we can welcome our summer retreat by showing our faith. So we're going to review what Senior Pastor taught us. So I'm happy to do that with you. The title of this message is Space Dimension and Science. So Immanuel Choir and this orchestra, thank you for the praise. And Deaconess Jang Sun-mi, thank you for your special performance. Father God sent Senior Pastor to this earth, and He let us feel the limitless goodness and love of Father God through Senior Pastor. So we give all thanks and glory to our Father God. All thanks and glory to God. Thank you. I give my sincere thanks to Senior Pastor, who showed goodness and love of Father God through His endless sacrifice. So thank you. My thanks should also go to Mrs. Bong Nim Lee, who embraces Manmin members, leads our prayer. So thank you. Pastor Soojin Lee, the acting senior pastor, who leads us in this moment of blessings. Thank you. My thanks should be directed to all the pastors, Levi workers, especially missionaries around the world, and pastors in branch churches, and the congregation. Thank you very much. As I am standing here, Nairobi Manmin Church in Congo, there are missionaries. Missionary Kim Jong-un and Pastor Han Jae-bum, they are working so hard. So pastors out there, they got greater faith. So I believe they are listening to this message very well. Every year, senior pastor has led us to ride on the flow of Holy Spirit and go to New Jerusalem through conferences and summer retreat. Every year, through Manmin summer retreat, senior pastor planted great faith with the power that moved the weather. It rained in 2013 summer retreat. The sky was covered with dark clouds. When senior pastor prayed on the altar, the dark clouds disappeared, and we could see clear sky in between, and the rain stopped. We experienced it. 2014, it rained from the very first day of summer retreat. However, it was a test for the faith of Manmin congregation. However, Manmin members had faith and confidence that there must be will of Father God as it rains. We gave thanks and joy to Father God without moving, and we listened to senior pastor's messages. Not a single member moved, and we passed the test, and we pleased our Father God. In 2015, 2016, 2017, in summer retreats, in the amazing love and blessing of Father God, beautiful, cool wind blew, even though it was so hot in this country. We had a very pleasant and beautiful summer retreat. Well, I have a testimony. In 2017, on the second day when there was a field games, senior pastor had a lunch, and then he moved to some different place. The temperature above the altar climbed up to 31 in Celsius. And then senior pastor came back to the altar, and I approached him to say hello to senior pastor, and I happened to look at the temperature, and I was so shocked. It was 31 in Celsius, but now the number dropped down in a couple of seconds to 29. How amazing! To cool down your room, well, you've got to turn on the air conditioner for about 10 minutes to lower the temperature by 2 or 3 degrees. However, it was outdoor, but in just a couple of seconds, the temperature dropped down by 2 or 3 degrees in Celsius. So I realized that how much Father God loves our senior pastor, and He guarantees our senior pastor's prayer. I felt the space of spirit once again that day. As I look back on that day, senior pastor taught us to ride on the flow of the Holy Spirit. In July 2017, there was a conference. And after that, in summer retreat, by the power that moved and changed the weather, the whole country had the warning about the scorching sun and heat. But Muzu Resort was so cool, and there was a cool breeze, and we had a beautiful summer retreat. 2017 was the year a senior pastor finished the seven-year justice. And in 2018, Manim family, Manim members were waiting for the time of blessing that Father God has promised. However, Father God allowed us to go through this moment of blessing now in His even greater providence. And our minds and our hearts have been revealed in this moment of blessing. But at the same time, He allowed us to realize and learn and become united and wait for 2019 summer retreat. I was asked to deliver a message tonight. So I was thinking, I refused. But what kind of message should I deliver? I thought to myself. Then I was reminded of senior pastor who received God's revelation through countless fastings and prayer and helped us realize the spiritual realm through His power. I was grateful to senior pastor that in this year, God will show us amazing wonders and signs and works that move the weather and change the weather through summer retreat. So, I would like to look into the message about space, dimension, and science, which was preached by senior pastor tonight. So, we are reviewing, okay? Actually, I studied in the space and dimension once again to deliver this message. And I thought about, you know, science as well. I hope that you can receive grace through this message. So many pastors and Christians today say that Father God is alive, He is Almighty, and Jesus saved us from our sins. However, they got no knowledge, especially spiritual knowledge about Father God. Some Christians don't have even spiritual experience, but that's to say, believe. So people cannot have faith easily. Some Christians go to church, but it's hard to possess faith. But there are scientists who are Christians. They try to prove God the Creator. They work hard. But even though they do not agree with the evolutionism, they have to stand against law of, you know, thermodynamics, which is the most basic of science. Well, let me tell you these things for your information. When a house is built about 100 or 200 years later, you know, it's natural for it to collapse. So the ordinary goes into, you know, chaos. 2,000 years ago, Father God sent Jesus to this earth, and through Jesus' ministry, He manifested signs and wonders to prove that Father God is alive and He is Almighty, and to show that there is spiritual space, heaven and hell. However, there were souls who were incited by the enemy, devil, and Satan. And even today, there are many people who lost their faith but go to destruction. But Father God is surely love. He sent senior pastor, and when senior pastor was piling up justice, He also piled up the power of Father God. Now, after the finishing the seven-year-long justice, Father God is preparing the most adequate time to conclude this human cultivation. So, I'm going to review space and time, space and dimension the senior pastor explained. And I'm going to tell you how scientists work to deny evolutionism, but explain creationism. But there are limits that science can do. But senior pastor delivered many messages, such as space and dimension and spiritual realm, and they contain many evidences to prove that there is spiritual space. So that's why the title of this message is Space, Dimension, and Science. Mami members came to learn physical world, fleshly world, spiritual space, how to use spiritual space and usage of spiritual space through senior pastor's messages, through his power, through his prayer. Well, spiritual space is completely different from fleshly space. And spiritual dimension is completely different from fleshly dimension. Something that is impossible in fleshly space is possible in spiritual space. As knowledge and civilization developed, you know, even in fleshly space, even though it is hot, cold winter, people made up a special place where, you know, they can grow some plants in cold winter day. When senior pastor delivered this message, he explained that Father God put the rod of Aaron, which was in the fleshly space, surrounded by the spiritual space, so that the rod of Aaron sprouted and then put forth buds and produced blossoms, and it bore ripe almonds. When Moses prayed to God, the Red Sea was departed, the bitter water turned into sweet water, and water gushed out from rock. It was all possible because fleshly space was covered with spiritual space. Many forefathers of faith used the spiritual space to manifest amazing works in the Bible, which took place also in the church. So let us delve into the concept of space and dimension once again, explained by a senior pastor. Space is the area, both physically and mentally. In the space, many of the objects can exist. Okay? Space is very easy to understand. However, dimension is not quite easy to understand. Well, I want to try to explain this, you know, dimension, but it's hard to understand. It's hard for me to understand too. Well, some students or professors who studied in physics or mathematics can understand the definition of dimension, you know, by, you know, explaining some, you know, coordinates of, you know, x-axis and y-axis. However, after I met senior pastor, I came to understand and have greater understanding of the concept of space. So, but senior pastor explained through the message of spiritual soul and body. So I'm going to explain dimension from the perspective of spirit, soul, and body. And then I will tell you about the space. Then you may have a greater understanding about, you know, dimension. So let me tell you about dimension from the perspective of spirit, soul, and body. There are lifeless things and things with life, such as in the stones, ground, iron, water. We cannot talk about its dimension, but we call it no dimension. But there is a thing that has life and it can breathe, but it doesn't move, such as trees and grass. They only breathe. So from the perspective of spirit and soul and body, we call it they are in the first dimension. They exist in the first dimension. They got no soul, they got no spirit. Now, there are birds, fish, and other animals. They can breathe, they can move, they have body, soul. So they belong to the second dimension. So animals exist in the second dimension. But human beings breathe, move, and they have spirit. So human beings belong to the third dimension. Lastly, our Father God and heavenly hosts and angels and cherubs and evil spirits, they are spiritual beings, so they belong to the fourth dimension. They are invisible to the eyes of man. First dimension objects, second dimension objects, such as, you know, animals, and human beings in the third dimension. They live on this earth together. However, they actually belong to their own respective dimensions. For example, the President of the United States, Donald Trump, bypassing the main street of, you know, Seoul, the citizens of Seoul will wave at him, right, to welcome him. we will, you know, wave at him, right? However, someone came out with his pet and welcomed him by waving his hand. However, that pet, that dog, cannot recognize Donald Trump because the dog belongs to the second dimension, and it cannot recognize a man in the third dimension. It cannot recognize him as Donald Trump. So spiritual sense, in a spiritual sense, those who belong to the third dimension, people, cannot see God in the fourth dimension. Just like a dog in the second dimension cannot recognize a man in the third dimension. So you and I, but you and I belong to the third dimension. But we know that there is the Holy Spirit who lives in our heart right now. We came to know about Father God in the fourth dimension. And in order to live with our Father God in heaven, we work so hard on this earth. Now, can you have a little bit of understanding about space? Now, Senior Pastor explained, you know, spaces where many, you know, phenomena, you know, take place. First of all, the physical space that we can see is the first dimension. Second dimension up to fourth dimension are called spiritual spaces. So there are two, second, third, and fourth the dimensions. When Father God began His creation, He divided heavens into four. 2 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 2 to 5, it tells us about the third heaven. So we came to know about there were many heavens, in other words, many different spaces. We were surprised. We thought, you know, there is only one sky. But after meeting Senior Pastor, we came to know about skies and heavens and spaces. So we are so blessed to know them. First sky, first heaven, first space belongs to this. It includes all the spirit, I mean, fleshly space, including this earth. Second heaven, second sky, second space is called an air in the Bible. And there is domain of light and domain of darkness. In the domain of light, there is the Garden of Eden. And the domain of darkness is the place where evil spirits work. And in the third dimension, there is our heaven. And in the fourth dimension, fourth heaven, there is a space for God the Trinity. When Father God created all these different space and dimensions, Father God set up the rules, which that is, the higher dimension, higher space can rule over the lower dimensions and the lower spaces. However, when the first dimension is surrounded by or enveloped inside your spiritual space, the spiritual things, spiritual phenomena can also take place in this, in the first space. So we learned how to use, you know, spiritual space as we enter the Holy Spirit. Daniel 3, verse 22 to 25, Daniel's three friends were put into a burning furnace. However, four men were walking inside the furnace, and the first person looked like a son of God's. Since these three friends were covered with spiritual space, they were not burned. When Senior Pastor delivered the message about this, he said there was a man like a God of, you know, the son of God's. And he was referring to God, the Holy Spirit. So since the Holy Spirit was there, the inside the furnace was covered with the fourth dimension, I mean, the space of fourth dimension. So even the scorching in the furnace, in the furnace heat, cannot burn in Daniel's three friends. Think about the Pakistan crusade and Chennai crusade in India. I believe you remember them, right? In Pakistan, The government of Pakistan actually allowed the crusade. However, the enemy devil and Satan incited the leaders of Islam, Muslims, to cancel that crusade. However, Father God heard the prayer of senior pastor and surrounded the place with spiritual space. So, a good minister, a member of the Pakistan cabinet, made a call to the officers in power and opened the stadium, and we were able to conduct a Pakistan crusade there. Through senior pastor's prayer, all the Pakistanis in the spiritual space were healed, converted to become Christians, welcome Jesus Christ as their Savior. And Father God is sending Pastor Kilteshik to Pakistan to, to lead many souls to heaven. There is a Lot and Lot's family. Genesis 19:29 says, "Thus it came about when God destroyed the cities of the valley, that God remembered Abraham and sent Lot out of the midst of the overthrow, when he overthrew the cities in which Lot lived." As God thought of Abraham, he put spiritual space over Lot and his family. So we can call this space as a space of Abraham. However, people inside the space of Abraham received a different kind of grace. Father God sent angels to save Lot's family. And Lot informed his family that the Sodom would be destroyed, and even his sons-in-law. However, sons-in-law of Lot didn't believe Lot, so they lost the chance of salvation. Father God gave them chance, but they didn't take the chance. What about life of Lot's wife? She knew there was a judgment, but she couldn't cast off her strong attachment to the world. So she turned back and she became the pillar of salt. Bitter water of Marah turned into sweet water. And that same thing happened in the church. One Mormon church is surrounded by sea. And even though they dug in a well, there was salty water. So one Mormon members believed that when senior pastor prayed, that salty seawater turned into drinkable sweet water. But senior pastor went to prayer house for 10 days. But he remembered one Mormon church and prayed for them. And Pastor Kim Myung-sul of One Mormon Church received senior pastor's prayer. By the inspiration of the Holy Spirit, senior pastor prayed so that the sweet seawater would turn into drinkable sweet water. One Mormon Church is about 400 kilometers away from Seoul. But by the power of God, that seawater turned into sweet water. But that water also contains the power of healing. So many people experienced that healing works of one sweet water. It was possible because Father God surrounded the place with light and put it into spiritual space. The enemy, devil, and Satan incited evil people to interfere senior pastor's ministry through broadcasting company. But Father God protected one church with the spiritual space so that the salty seawater would turn into drinkable sweet water. As he listened to senior pastor's prayer. And the same year, from 2000, Father God opened a door to world ministry through Uganda Crusade, and it was broadcast all over the world through CNN. And there was a great event of twist, and senior pastor was able to do his world mission and three-year-long Israel mission. So, I would like to add some more examples that people were protected in the spiritual space formed in the fleshly space so that you can understand more easily about the spiritual space. Isaiah 43 verse 2 says, "When you pass through the waters, I will be with you, and through the rivers, they will not overflow you. When you walk through the fire, you will not be scorched, nor will the flame burn you." Now, in chapter 27 of Acts, we can find people whose life were saved thanks to, you know, space of Apostle Paul. Apostle Paul was arrested to Rome. He was on the ship, and there was great waves. Then Acts 27:24 says, "Do not be afraid, Paul. You must stand before Caesar. And behold, God has granted you all those who are sailing with you." And Apostle Paul told all the sailors about this, and they were saved. Thanks to Apostle Paul, the ship was protected by spiritual space by Father God. So, the wind could not harm the ship. When senior pastor came back from Ulleung-do in 1986, there was a typhoon, so no ships could sail out. There was a huge waves out there. However, senior pastor and the members of Light and Salt Mission should have come back to Seoul. But there was no ship sailing out, but there was one fishing boat. So they hopped into the boat, and they decided to go to a small harbor in Ulleung-do area. In the midst of the sea, there was no single ship out there except that fishing boat. There was a huge wave, and all the senior pastor and other members felt like they were in the midst of the tunnel of waves. But they held their hands together and they sang praises. But not a single big wave hit that fishing boat. They saw those waves changing their direction. Since senior pastor was there, the boat was covered with spiritual space, so that waves, big waves, could not harm the fishing boat, but changed its directions. Brothers and sisters, Father God saved Lot by the space of Abraham. Father God departed the Red Sea through the space of Moses. And water gushed off from the rock. In the space of Paul, the ship was not wrecked, and all the people on that boat were saved. And he is still working together. In this end time, Father God explained us about spiritual in space so that we can solve all our problems in this fleshly space. It was possible because Father God surrounded us with spiritual space thanks to our senior pastor. So, we are solving all our problems, we are protected. We are protected from, you know, car accident, a baby who suffer from, you know, grapes, Congolians who suffer from Ebola virus, the people in Florida who were about to be, you know, threatened by hurricanes. They were all protected. So all thanks and glory to our Father God. Father God explain through our senior pastor how to use the spiritual space. As acting senior pastor, you know, Pastor Su Jin Lee prayed, the great fire didn't, you know, attack one of our mommy members who was serving in the army. Now, using and adapting spiritual spaces, which cannot be explained through science. But how creation scientists explain about them. As you listen to this message, I hope you can gain great gain. You will gain great strength. Students in school learn evolutionism. Some creation scientists say, students learn evolutionism, and church collects, you know, gleans all the people who are left out. So that's why senior pastor asked us to publish, you know, creation science. So I give thanks to all those who are working hard for this. So what is science? It's hard to define. It's not easy. Well, just let me tell you what I learned and what I... So if you're a scientist, you know, please bear it with me, okay? Well, science is the study to learn and use the physical space. To understand in the physical space, they use all kinds of studies and researches to find the cause and result, right? They observe first, and they think and study, and they express what they think, and they adopt it later. And they make terms, like the theories and laws. When their theories got confirmed by evidences, they call it law. Such as, there is the law of, you know, buoyancy. You know, the lighter things, you know, float up and, you know, heavy things, you know, sink down. And there is the law of, you know, gravitation. Okay? I believe you learned it. And there is also a chemical reactions. You know, they mix this with something and there is a chemical reactions. Right? However, if there is something exceptions, they cannot call it a law. Because to make it, they make their theory as a law, they have to come up with the evidences, you know, which can explain that, you know, phenomena. All living things eventually die, and you will eventually die. That we call the law of death. However, there is one who broke this law of death, who revived Lazarus. He is Jesus Christ, the Son of God, God the Creator. He shed all his blood and water on the cross. He died according to the law of death. However, he broke this law. He resurrected in 3 days, and he showed his body to his disciples. Father God said, if you eat from the tree of the knowledge of good and evil, you will surely die. That's the law of God. However, Eve was incited by the serpent. She heard, if you eat it, you may die. It was manipulating the law of God. Scientists discover what God said, the principles of nature. But scientists also know that they have limits. They research, study, measure all kinds of physical objects. However, if there is non-physical objects such as heart, they cannot observe, they cannot study. We all have heart. Now, does that heart inside or outside? I'm not talking about your actual heart, okay? We know there is heart, but it is invisible. So scientists cannot observe this non-physical thing. It does exist in this space, but there are objects that are invisible. So scientists have to study what they see, but they cannot study this non-physical thing. However, the Bible is talking about spiritual realm that goes beyond the limit of fleshly space. So, in other words, Bible is talking about spiritual space that science cannot explain. Father God sent His only begotten Son, Jesus, to this earth. And our Lord Jesus Christ proves that Father God is our Father, spiritual Father. He also said in John 14, verse 2 to 3, in my Father's house are many dwelling places. If it were not so, I would have told you. For I go to prepare a place for you. If I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you to myself, that where I am, there you may be also. Jesus died, but He resurrected in 3 days. He gave us hope for resurrection, and He ascended into heaven. Then angels appear, and they said, as in Acts 1:11, "Men of Galilee, why do you stand looking into the sky? This Jesus, who has been taken up from you into heaven, will come in just the same way as you have watched him go into heaven." So, our Lord told us God is our spiritual Father, and there is heaven. And we will together live with our Father God in heaven. Of course, there are pastors who wanted to know about spiritual realm through their prayers. However, they couldn't understand all those difficult verses in the Bible. However, we learned from our senior pastor about creation works for 6 days. The reason why Father God put the tree of the knowledge of good and evil in the Garden of Eden. Spiritual, spirit and space, 7-year retribution, and measure of faith in heaven and hell. I'm talking about dimension and space. Scientists tried to explain the miracles that Jesus manifested using their knowledge and wisdom, but it cannot be explained. Let's think about Jesus' miracle, turning water into wine. But people cannot understand this miracle. Why? Because it is against the chemical reaction. The H2O, the water, cannot turn into alcohol. They gotta put something into water to turn that water into something else. But nothing was added to the water, but that water turned into wine. So people, ordinary people, cannot understand it. There is a miracle of 5 loaves and 2 fish in Matthew chapter 14. And 5,000 people were fed. However, there were 12 baskets left. Well, by our common sense, what we maybe have in a 20 or more than 20 bags of flour to, you know, bake, you know, loaves of bread, which can feed more than 5,000 people, right? However, only with 5 loaves and 2 fish, 5,000 were fed. It was directly against the law of conservation of mass. The mass of the system must remain constant over time, as system's mass cannot change, so quantity can neither be added nor be removed. Matthew chapter 14, verses 22-27, Jesus put his disciples onto the boat, and on about 4 o'clock in the morning, Jesus walked over the sea and approached his disciples. Well, objects that is heavier than water should sink under the water. That's the law of the nature. However, Jesus floated over the water and he walked over the surface of the water. It is against the law of nature, right? So people can understand. Thanks to senior pastor's prayer, the fetus inside the woman's womb, their genders were changed from boy to girl, from girl to boy. When senior pastor prayed, spiritual space of the fourth dimension covered the woman's womb, so the girl changed into a boy. When senior pastor prayed in Honduras Crusade, a girl who lost one eye but put a fake eye was able to see through both eyes. It was the work of recreation. When senior pastor prayed, a grape that went into a lung of a baby disappeared. Since the lung was covered with spiritual space, the grape was gone. But the worldly people cannot believe it. Well, Father God set a law of universe. And people in this fleshly space cannot get away from this law of universe. But there are miracles that go against this law of universe. So people cannot believe miracles that break their law of universe. But Father God set this law. So he can break this law. He can change this law. That's what creation scientists believe. And they say, who's the one who set this law and who can break this law is the God, the Creator. So, miracles and the Bible are true. It means God is our creator who set this law. So scientists say with confidence that thanks to these miracles in the Bible, we believe in Jesus Christ. That's what they say. Well, they didn't prove it. However, their scientists cannot overcome their limit because they cannot prove more than that. Well, one of the most important law of nature is the law of death. As I told you earlier, every living thing should die. So, you and I all shall die. But there is one who survived this law. That is Jesus Christ. So we believe that Jesus' resurrection. John 11, verse 25 and 26 says, Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life. He who believes in me will live even if he dies. And everyone who lives and believes in me will never die. Do you believe this? Back then, he said to Martha. Then Martha said, My Lord, that's true. You are Jesus Christ. She said, Yes and Amen. However, when Jesus asked her to move the rock which blocked the grave of Lazarus, even though Martha believed Jesus, she could not show her faith. Brothers and sisters, 2,000 years ago, disciples and those who followed Jesus listened to Jesus for 3 years. He witnessed the ministry of Jesus. They witnessed Jesus who broke the law of death. And then they believed that Jesus was the Messiah, Christ. Except new members in Manmin, more than 10, 20, 30 years, we learned from senior pastor who explained all the miracles in the Bible. We witnessed them using spiritual space. And he showed that Father God is alive. We witnesses. In the spiritual space, thanks to our senior pastor's prayer, so many diseases were healed. And there were so many people who were protected from all kinds of accidents and disasters. However, there were people who couldn't have possessed, just like the son-in-laws of Lot, like Lot's wife, who went back to the world. In this course of the moment of blessing, some people say, Senior Pastor, I love you. Senior Pastor, thank you for solving all kinds of secrets of the Bible. Senior Pastor, thanks to your power of prayer, I'm healed, I'm protected. There were people like that, but they left their beloved church, and they're hurting our Manmin congregation. But our senior pastor still prays to Father God that, please forgive them. They do not know what they are doing. All Manmin congregation should pray just like our senior pastor does. But you, missionaries, pastors, we all trust our senior pastor. So we help our pastor Sujin Lin and protect this church. So I thank you for that. Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, I would like to finish my message with the Africa Mission Report. When senior pastor said in the Revelation of John, you know, every day is the Lord's day in heaven. But let's regard this is the global day. Every day is a global day. And you are an acting missionary, okay? So let me tell you about the African mission as I conclude this message. Let me tell you how Father God has worked in Nairobi Manmin Church. And second, and how Father God is working in Kenya. And how Father God is working in Africa. from May to July. Let me report it to you, okay? First, Nairobi Manmin Church. There was a government act called the Uduma number from May to June. All the citizens of Kenya must be issued with a certificate, like an ID card. And there was a cooperation request by the government. So, along with Nairobi Manmin Church, three other churches provided the church as the space for that issuing ID. From early 6 o'clock in the morning till 6 o'clock in the evening, citizens came to our church and they were issued the ID card. They got to take a picture, they got to, record their, the fingerprints. But we set all the chairs so that, the government officers should work freely, in our church. Well, I started Nairobi Manmin Church 19 years ago. In the first year, there were 2,000 people gathered. And then when I delivered the message in other place, 300 more people came to Manmin Church. So there were other pastors who spread bad rumors about Nairobi Manmin Church. They said, give money to the new members. There were bad rumors about Nairobi Manmin Church in Kenya, as I told you before. So when they lost their children, they came to Manmin Church. But when I prayed, all the lost children were discovered. They were all found. So now they don't come to Nairobi Manmin Church anymore. But back then we had that kind of difficulties. And in the past, there were people who didn't rent their houses to Manmin members because the Nairobi Manmin Church was experiencing rapid growth. But we prayed to forgive them because they did not know what they were doing. But after those years, this happened. There were people who heard about bad rumors about Nairobi Manmin Church. They were setting alert. However, as time passed by, neighbors said to each other that it is most convenient to register their ID card in Manmin Church. Well, listen carefully. We set up space. We gave them chairs. When neighbors came, the other churches didn't provide chairs to the neighbors. So neighbors didn't like those churches. However, when they came to Manmin Church, they could sit down. They could sit down on our chairs that we provided. So they were touched. So there are many African people who are very selfish. So, in this case, they had to stand in lines for 3 or 4 hours, standing up. Well, they keep the order very well. So they stand in line for over 3 or 4 hours. But we provided with chairs. So those visiting neighbors came to Manmin Church. However, they said, after they came to Manmin Church, Nairobi Manmin Church is beautiful. I would like to come to this church to give worship service. They started to talk like that. We set in the TV sets so that they could watch the power of God. And they were able to listen to messages. And those government officers who worked from early in the morning, we gave them a place for rest. And we provided them with the coffee and tea. We served them. So they were greatly touched. So the chief of government officers visited Nairobi Manmin Church, and they reported to the government. The Nairobi Manmin Church was the most cooperative.
I got a call from Nairobi Manmin Church.
In the process of, you know, issuing the ID card, 200 officers and had discussion, and only two pastors of Manmin Church were invited to their meeting. I just heard that they attended. I didn't hear there was any other pastor from other church who were attending that meeting. But two pastors from Nairobi Manmin Church were attending. So, to register their ID, neighbors came to Nairobi Manmin Church, and they said to their friends to go to Nairobi Manmin Church. So, more people came to Manmin Church to register their ID. And so they came to know about Nairobi Manmin Church, and they opened their hearts to Manmin Church. So many of them came to Manmin Church later on. So when pastors of Manmin Church preached the gospel to them, you know, those neighbors agreed to them, and they opened their hearts. So many people, more and more people are coming to Nairobi Manmin Church. Well, let me show you. They are the officials who were, you know, registering their fingerprints. And there are neighbors who are waiting, sitting down on the chairs. And they were watching senior pastors in the power of God. After that, it took like a, 200 more people came, new members. So every month or twice a month, we deliver a special lecture on them, and I gave them the prayer of healing, prayer for healing. There was a lady who, by the name of Loda. She came to Manmin Church, and she was watching video of God, power of God, and she was greatly touched, and she came to Manmin Church later on. And she received prayer for the sick, and she was healed of all kinds of pains on her back and her body. So she testified to her healing, and now she's attending even Wednesday service and Friday service. That's the newcomer education. They are elders in the presence of men's mission and women's mission. And they were bowing down to newcomers. And then we said, we will serve you. That's what we said. And then I usually teach them twice a month or once a month. There were about, and then 200 people were, you know, registered to our church on that single day. And I pray for the sick, and Father God healed them. And then Loda, who was healed on that place, and testified to her healing. Loda. She said, I came to this church because I was pleased with the words of God.
So
when she testified, you know, she testified to her healing, and she testified to her delight in the words of God. Second, in an area of Kenya, a pastor registered to Manmin Church. A female member of Nairobi Manmin Church preached the gospel. Introduced a Manmin Church and the senior pastor's message to a pastor. And Pastor Francisco Deru visited Nairobi Manmin Church along with his wife, the assistant pastors, and church workers. And they went back to church. And they wanted to make their church a Manmin brand church. He put up a postal sign calling his church as Manmin Church. and he is requesting handkerchief prayer meeting and pastor seminar. And there was a handkerchief prayer meeting in July 25th, and there was pastor seminar in 26th. About 80 pastors and bishops attended, and they heard the message. Among them, there was a pastor, Bishop Gary, a bishop for Maasai, and he was greatly touched. And he made a request to have in the Bible school. And I told him that if you have a committee with the 10 bishops and the agreed signature of the neighboring pastors in number of 150, then I will open Bible school. And he was pleased, and I was touched by him too. From the first day it rained when I had the handkerchief prayer meeting, but I delivered the message under the rain. And there were about 200 people under the roof of the building. And it moved the hearts of so many neighbors. And the next day, there was pastor's seminar. It's a very small city. And here is Bishop Gary, who is very famous, and he attended this, you know, pastor's seminar, pastor's conference. And I was requested to have Bible school. So if you have 10 bishops and 150 pastors agreeing assignment, then I will open a Bible school here. That's what I said to them. He said, Amen.
And then there is a republic, Democratic Republic of the Congo. But this here, there is a Republic of Congo.
There was the pastors' conference and handkerchief prayer meeting in Point Lunuwa in Republic of the Congo in June. And 38 pastors registered their church as a branch, mommy branch churches. About 700 pastors attended, and there was a Bishop Rogers. I told them about the reason of God's putting the tree of the knowledge of good and evil in Garden of Eden. And when I delivered the message, and when they received the prayer for the sick, most of them were healed. And they wanted to continue to listen to senior pastor's messages. And Bishop Rogers said he would like to make his church Mommy Brain Church. He would like to become a servant who leads many souls. And he even, you know, saw me off at the airport. But he was building a new church. Since the bishop was so good, well, actually, I prayed for the sick.
Yeah. And then she couldn't see, but she was able to see after. And then they visited me at hotel, and then I prayed for those in the bishop and his wife.
And
they were elders of his church. And this Bishop Rogers came to the airport. And in the advice, you know, the governor of that state, you know, came to the airport. And there is a, let me tell you about the mission in Namibia. There is a lady member, Selma, in Nairobi Mamin Church. I believe you read her testimony in Mamin News. Well, as her husband had the business in Nairobi, you know, she moved to Nairobi. She converted from in a Muslim to Christian. She committed suicide for 3 times, but she failed. To get comfort, she went to Muslim, and then she met her husband and then married. But she was not healed in a Muslim temple. She went to many hospitals, but she could not be healed. She even lost her memory, so she could not come back to her house once she went out. So her husband hated it. She couldn't do her chores. Then a member of Nairobi Mamin Church worked for her. And thanks to her, she came to Nairobi Mamin Church. Well, she actually asked her, "I don't know about the churches in Kenya. Which church should I go?" She prayed like that. Her daughter, at the age of 10, had a dream that, "Tell your mom to go to Mamin Church." Her daughter had this dream. So thanks to the member of Nairobi Mamin Church at home, started to come to Nairobi Mamin Church. She believed that it is the church the Father God introduced. However, her husband was Muslim. But she came to Mamin Church and she was completely healed of her diseases thanks to senior pastor's prayer for the sick. However, her neighbors informed her husband about this, and her husband started to persecute her. You know, she attended in the afternoon service without telling her husband, but you know, her husband persecuted her so much. Her husband sent all her children to Khartoum, the capital city of Sudan, so that they would not be affected by his wife, the Christian wife. However, Selma went to Daniel Prayer Meeting to Nairobi Mamin Church, which was about 16 kilometers away from her house. She prayed every night, and Father God showed her the vision of rapture 3 times. Then she recovered her memory power. Now she was able to memorize 100 Bible verses. So I asked her to memorize all the 100 Bible verses. So the old Mamin congregation were surprised to see her. So Father God worked with her. She went to Namibia to solve the passport problem. Now she met a pastor. She introduced Mamin Church and senior pastor and the power of God. And that pastor was touched. And she asked her to come to his church to testify. So she testified in his church. And the congregation, which was about more than 1,000, the pastor asked her to testify again on Sunday. So she went to church and testified again on Sunday. And the pastor of that church came to Nairobi Mamin Church, and he said he wanted to learn more about senior pastor's messages. So let me show you how she testified in Namibia. But that's what she testified in church in Namibia. First day, and the second Sunday.
사진을 보내왔는데 사진 찍은 사람이 잘 찍지를 못해서 잘
The photographer could not take the whole the picture of the church. But the church was a great big church. But thanks to the works of the Holy Spirit, you know.
그다음에 케냐의 선교문을 열어주시면서.
The door to the mission in Namibia opened. I got invitation from more than the 7 countries. Let me conclude this message. I review the senior pastor's messages about space and dimension and how creation scientists work. By faith. All the impossible things in the physical space have been solved thanks to Jesus and God the Creator and all the disciples of Jesus in the Bible. And we believe them in the Bible. However, worldly people, even some Christians, do not believe miracles and signs and wonders manifested by Jesus. They don't believe in the works of God's power. However, God is love. In this end time, Father God wants to save many souls, so He sent senior pastor to this earth. Senior pastor opened the spiritual realm through his countless fastings and prayers, and he is manifesting power of God. And he proves that Father God is alive and He is the Creator, and he explained to us about space and dimension. And it became our faith and strength. Mom and congregation, we heard about secrets of the Bible, the senior pastor explained. And we learned how to use spiritual space. And we are witnesses of the senior pastors in the manifestations of God's power and miracles and signs and wonders. So many people were healed. They were protected from disasters and accidents. Thanks to prayer of Pastor Soo-jin Lee, a fire from North Korea stopped by DMZ area. Thanks to our Mamin brother's prayer request, we heard this testimony. Thanks to this brother who requested by faith, and thanks to Pastor Soo-jin Lee's prayer, Father God worked by surrounding that place with the spiritual space. The fire stopped. So brothers and sisters of Mamin, I thought about 300 warriors of Gideon. The enemies were Midianites and Amalekites. They were great in number, said the Bible. But there were about like 32,000 Israelite soldiers. It was no match. However, Father God said something amazing. Your number is too much, so leave only 300. As you know very well, through these 300 warriors of Gideon, those countless Midianite soldiers were defeated. 300 warriors won the victory. Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, thanks to the teaching of senior pastor and his prayer and the power, you passed the test. Some didn't. However, those of you who are here passed that test, and then you are standing even more firmly. What you got to do now is the work of work done by 300 warriors of Gideon. But I'm short of so many things to become strength to senior pastor. What should I do? You may think to yourself like this. However, think about what 300 warriors did. Gideon depended on God. He just obeyed God. He blew the trumpet. He broke the jar of light. And they cried, that's it. The enemies, you know, fight each other. 300 warriors didn't even swing a sword. What they had was just trumpet, torch, and a jar. What does it mean? Father God is governing everything in His providence. All we gotta do is just obey Him and practice His will with faithfulness. In this end time, Father God is accomplishing His will in providence through our senior pastor in this Manmin church. And that Father God gave us this moment of blessing to test us, to make us perfect. So all we gotta do is just believe in Father God and trust our senior pastor, whom is loved by our Father God, and remember His words. Hold on to the words of Father God. And you got to find yourself where you should be found and show your faithfulness. 300 warriors. That braveness. They're so brave. And they were ready to risk their lives before those in a limitless, you know, enemies. They just blew the trumpet. They held on to the torch, and it was a great act of faith. Brothers and sisters, just like the 300 warriors of Gideon, we gotta trust in our shepherd. Just as 300 warriors depended on Gideon and God. So, show our obedience, and trust, and faith, and show our faith before Father God, just like 300 warriors. Next week, there is Manmin Summer Retreat. May you glorify our Father God in the spiritual space of our Shepherd. And may you receive the works of healing and answer. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, I pray. Let's think of the message and pray together.
앞으로 저희들에게 주신 그 사명 잘 감당하여 수많은 영혼을 구원하는 만민의 가족들에게 축복하여 주시기를 원합니다. 다음 주에는 만민 하계 수련회가 있습니다. 저희들 강사님이 함께 하시고 그리고 모든 성도들의 응답과 치료로 함께하는 시간으로 인도하시고 축복하여 주옵소서. 우리 주 예수 그리스도로 기도하옵나이다. 아멘.
Let's receive Senior Pastor's prayer for those sick on screen. Lay your hand on the sick part of your body. If you are not sick, lay your hand on your chest and receive this prayer for the desires of your heart. Hallelujah, Almighty Father God of love. Please lay your hands on all believers who are receiving this prayer now. Show your works that transcend space and time on those who are receiving this prayer on the internet and through satellites, and on GCN, in brain churches and local sanctuaries around the world. Give them the faith to believe and drive away all negative thoughts and doubts. Drive away all tests and trials as well. From head to toe, all entrails, joints, nerves, tissues and cells, whatever their sick part may be, burn them with the fire of the Holy Spirit and with the original light. In the name of Jesus Christ, I command the enemy devil and Satan, all diseases, germs and viruses and infirmities, go away. May the light come. Father God, please scorch all the terminal and incurable diseases with the fire of the Holy Spirit and drive away all endemic diseases such as malaria. All contagious diseases such as cold, flu and fever, go away. Father, protect them from all kinds of germs and viruses. And heal them of all stomach, lung, liver, breast, uterine, and intestinal cancers. AIDS, leukemia, cerebral apoplexy, high and low blood pressure, diabetes, thyroid diseases, heart, lung, women's diseases, and all inflammations be cleansed and go away. Heal them of polio, stroke, arthritis, and herniated discs.
back pain, headache, neuralgia, and all other pains go away. Epilepsy, autism, depression, neurosis, and other mental diseases go away. All kinds of paralysis be loosened. You get up, walk, and leap. Let the eyes see well. Let the ears hear well. Let the blind come to see, the deaf come to hear, and mute come to speak. Heal them of the after effects of all kinds of accidents and fix their broken bones. Let the heat and burning sensation go away. Restore them from burns. Let there be no burning scar left. Be cleansed from all kinds of drug addictions, poisoning, and substance abuse. Let the dead nerves, tissues, and cells be regenerated. God, bring the dead back to life. Give them the blessing of conception. May you receive the blessing of conception. In the name of Jesus Christ, I command the enemy devil and Satan, the ruler of the air, go away, and their servants also go away. Go away, you evil, unclean, false, and deceitful spirits, separating spirits and all forces of darkness. Loosen the bonds of wickedness. Darkness, you go away. May the light come. Father God, please give them strength to cry out in prayer, to cast off sin, and to be sanctified. As their soul prosper, let all things go well with them. Let their family be evangelized. Protect them from all kinds of accidents and disasters throughout this week, and bless them to lead a prosperous life without any problems. With the firewall of the Holy Spirit, with heavenly hosts and angels, and with your blazing eyes, protect all your children, their family, workplace, and business. Give our students wisdom and understanding, and give them fervor and passion to study hard. Keep their hearts and minds from the worldly things, and let our students love Father God all the more fervently. Whether your children eat or drink, whatever they may do, let them do it all for the glory of Father God. Let them say, I met God, I experienced God, I received answers and blessings. Let them testify like this. Father God, thank you. Be glorified alone. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen. Amen. 愛の主、それは命与える救いの道。